This video is proudly brought to you by Hovatek. Hovatek. Just a button away.
In this video tutorial, I'll be explaining how to use SNWrite tool, also known as SNWriter. Now, in previous guides, I had explained how to fix null IMEI and Wi-Fi 0x10 NVRAM errors using either MTK Engineering or Wi-Fi.exe manual editing and creation. But the limitation of those methods is that once you do a factory reset, they revert to the previous state, in the sense that if you write IMEI to your phone using the MTK Engineering method and you do a factory reset, it's very possible your IMEI disappears, so you are back to null IMEI. Or if you are having the 0x10 NVRAM error before the fix, once you do a factory reset, you are back to that error. So they are basically temporary, you know, fixes. Not like they are not effective, but they just disappear once you do a factory reset. Now, the advantage of using SNWrite tool is that you have a more permanent fix, in the sense that even if you do a factory reset, your IMEI still remains, and your Wi-Fi MAC address and the rest, your 0x10 errors is gone for good, even if you do a factory reset. That's the one advantage you have when you use SNWrite tool or SNWriter. Now, the downside, I wouldn't call it a downside per se, but one disadvantage, let me put it that way, of SNWrite tool is that you need to have the MD1DB and the APDB files for the phone you are trying to fix. And these files are located in the firmware for that phone. So unless you have a firmware with those two files in them, you will not be able to use SNWrite tool. Excuse me. So you need those two files basically for SNWrite tool. That is why I say it's kind of a downside. But with the other methods, you do not need any files, just the phone, and you are good to go. Alright. So before you can use SNWrite tool, you need to have your drivers installed. So I'll be showing you how to install drivers for featured phones and Mediatek Android phones. Ideally I should not be taking you through this guide of installing drivers, but just to give you a start to finish approach, I will just take a few minutes out to put you through that. Alright, so for featured phones, all you have to do is download the drivers. You can check the guide at the forum, the SNWrite tool guide at the forum. You'll find the link to download these drivers. Then you just open the folder and you double tap install driver, and that is that. Now for the MTK USB VCOM drivers, you need to disable driver signature verification if you're using a Windows 8 or Windows 10 PC. We already dropped a guide at the forum, and you can check our YouTube channel for the guide on how to disable signature verification on a Windows 8 or 10 PC. So you do not have any error during the Mediatek VCOM driver installation. But if you're using a Windows 7 PC, you do not need to do that. It's disabled by default. There's no setting that will block your driver installation by default on a Windows 7 PC. But for Windows 8 and Windows 10, you need to disable that. Now, the reason is that this Mediatek USB VCOM driver you're looking at is an unsigned driver. It is not signed. So Windows 8 and 10 tend to block the installation of unsigned drivers unless you disable that check. You understand? So that we are trying to do on a Windows 8 and 10 PC. Alright, so I get down to installation of Mediatek USB VCOM drivers, and you would want to open device manager. For that, you press the window button and you type device manager. Let me just drag this here. Alright, so once in device manager, what you'd want to do is select any item on the list, any item at all. Then you click on action, add legacy hardware, next. Install the hardware that I manually select from a list. Next, you click on hard disk. Now you click on the browse button and you open, you navigate to the location of the USB VCOM drivers. So here's the parent folder. So you open Mediatek USB VCOM drivers, USB VCOM driver. Now, if you're using a Windows 7 PC, if you're using a Windows 7, 8 or 10 PC, this is the folder you select, the Windows 7 folder. But for Vista and XP, you select the ones above. Now, this will work, as I said, this will work for Windows 7, Windows 8 and Windows 10. So you just open that. Now, you need to select the right one for your phone's architecture. If you're using a 32-bit PC, you don't select this. If you're using a 64-bit PC, you want to select this. Now, to check which your laptop is, you click on computer, right click on computer properties. Then here you are, system type 64-bit. So mine is 64-bit PC. So I'll go ahead and select the 64-bit version and I click on open and I click on OK. As you can see, the driver is not digitally signed, as I earlier mentioned. Click on next. And you wait for installation to begin. Okay, you get this prompt. This is warning you. This telling you that the driver you're about to install is not digitally signed. So, do you want to go ahead installing it? I click on install this driver. Even though it's not digitally signed. So, the idea behind the digital signature is just to ensure you're not installing a harmful driver. You know, so that's why they always check the digital signature of whatever it is they're trying to install, just for your own protection. Alright, so this is still installing, and in a few seconds I should be getting a message verifying that or confirming that installation was successful. Alright, the following hardware was installed. Mediatek USB VCOM port, good. Alright, so to verify, I just come down. Now I can see my Mediatek USB VCOM port. Now, don't be alarmed by these yellow triangles. The reason why you are seeing this is that the drivers I've installed are not signed drivers. Alright, so it's just like a warning. Windows is telling you these drivers are not signed. It doesn't mean they will not work, but they just might not work because we cannot verify that they are original or from an authentic source. So that's why you're having yellow triangle. It doesn't mean it will not work. Alright, so we get down to using SNRite tool proper. Now you would want to open the SNRite tool folder. Okay, in SNRite tool, you'd want to scroll down. You right click on SNRite, I run as administrator. You might just double click, but the reason why I prefer to run as admin is that you might run into some permission issues, you understand? So it's best to just run as admin if you can. So under COM port, you have your USB VCOM. I already installed that. Under target type, you just select your feature phone, smartphone, or any on the list. I'm using a Tecno M3 here, so mine is a smartphone. I select that. Now next, we click on system config. Now at this point, let me hide this so I can drag this fellow down. Good. Now at this point, you'd now want to decide what you intend to write. If you intend to write your IMEI, Bluetooth address, Wi-Fi address, MAC address, and the rest. So at this point you decide. So let's say I want to write IMEI. I just click on the IMEI button. Now don't forget that it is, just in case I didn't mention that, which I know I didn't mention that, it's illegal to change your IMEI in certain countries. So ensure you're not breaking any rules when writing an IMEI to your phone. That being said, you tick IMEI, then under IMEI option, you select the appropriate option depending on how many SIM slots your phone has. For most MTK phones, it's dual SIM, so I have dual IMEI. I just have this ticked here. So since the IMEI 1 and IMEI 2 will not be the same, I don't need to tick this. I'm just okay with IMEI, dual IMEI. All right. So for MD1, you click on this, and then you open the firmware folder where the MD1 and APDB files are. Now for the MD1DB folder, it's going to look something like this: BP, LG, UI, info, custom, something like this. This is what it's going to look like. So you select that and you click on open. Now for the APDB file, you open the firmware folder also. It will have APDB in the name, as you can see. You highlight that and open. So I'm good to go for writing my IMEI. I click on save. Alright, next you click on you find yourself back on the home screen of SN Writer. So you click on start. Now at this point you insert IMEI 1, IMEI 2. So let's see. Alright, so let's say I'm writing for IMEI 1 and 2. Once I'm done with that, I click on OK. So at this point, you switch off the phone, still with battery inside, and then you connect it to the PC via USB cord. Don't forget, you're not supposed to hold down any button. Just switch off with the battery in and connect to the PC. So your phone might come up, you might see the boot animation. That is because SN Writer is trying to boot the phone into meta mode. So do not interrupt, just sit back and watch writing happen. Alright, so I have the pass, so that means write was successful for the IMEI. Now let's say I want to write, okay, I'm done with that. Let's say I want to write Wi-Fi or MAC address, for example. Let's say Wi-Fi address. All I'd have to do is to tick Wi-Fi address. MD1 and APDB files are already loaded. You can reload them just to be sure, but they're already loaded here. So I click on save. Next, I click on start. So now for the Wi-Fi address, if you check a valid Wi-Fi address, you see that they are often separated by a colon. So you'd find your Wi-Fi address looking something like, let me get an example. So mine is something like this: BC colon B3 colon 08 colon CB colon CO colon F6. So let's say this is my Wi-Fi MAC, my Wi-Fi address. So what you are going to enter in SN Write 2 is the same thing, only that you remove the colon. So we have this, and then okay. Now at this point you want to connect the phone to the PC while switched off with battery inside, without holding any button. Do not hold any button on the phone. Alright, you just connect it while it's switched off with battery in it. So it's going to meta mode, and alright, so we have a pass. So it's going to be the same procedure if you are going with barcode, Bluetooth address, Ethernet MAC address, and the rest. It's just going to be the same procedure. Alright, so that is basically how to use SN Write 2.